Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I will show you how to create striped patterns in Illustrator. We are going to make a seamless horizontal stripe pattern, a vertical stripe pattern, and a diagonal stripe pattern. So open Illustrator and let's get started. We are going to start with the horizontal stripes. So set your fill color and remove the stroke. Then using a rectangle tool, create your first stripe. Change to the selection tool and while holding down the Alt key, click on the first stripe and drag it down. Also hold down the Shift key to position it right under the first stripe. Now change the fill color of the second stripe and select both of them and group them by pressing Ctrl G. This will be our first pattern tile. To create the pattern, just select both shapes and then go to Object, Pattern, Make. As you can see, we have a seamless pattern, so just press Done to save it. The new pattern will now appear in the swatches panel. So select the pattern swatch and then draw a shape. You now have a perfect seamless pattern. You can also apply it to the different shape, like to a circle. Now we are going to create the second pattern. So select the shape and rotate it to create vertical stripes. Right click on it and go to Transform, Rotate. Enter 90 degrees next to the angle and click OK. So we have our vertical pattern tile and all we have to do is dragging to the swatches panel. If you want to test it, just select the pattern swatch and apply it to a shape. As you can see, this is a perfectly seamless vertical stripes pattern. If you want to change the color of the stripes, just double click on the pattern swatch in the swatches panel and using the selection tool, select one of the stripes and apply a new color swatch from the swatches panel. Then click done to save it. As you can see, we have a different color applied to the circle and a different color here in the swatches panel. So now I'm going to delete these shapes and we are going to create a diagonal pattern. If you want to create a diagonal striped pattern, it's important to have a square artboard. So if you want to change the size of your artboard, just click on the artboard tool and enter a new size here. For this pattern, I'm going to use the line segment tool. So select the line segment tool, remove the fill color and set a stroke color. I'm also going to set a larger stroke, like 40 points, I think that's enough. So while holding down the shift key, draw a line. The line has to be bigger than your artboard. We're going to use the rotate tool again to rotate it to a 45 degrees angle. So go to transform, rotate and enter 45 here. Click OK to save it. Now move the line to the middle of your artboard. We need to use the line that's larger than the diagonal line. So if your line is larger, then move it here in the upper left corner. Now I'm going to select this and go to Object, Transform, Move. I want to move this line from the upper left corner to the lower right corner. To do that, I'm going to enter 12 inches for the horizontal position and 12 inches for the vertical. My artboard is 12 by 12 inches, so you have to enter the width and height of your artboard. Then press copy to move the line. We are going to create a diagonal pattern by using the blend tool. So select both lines and then go to Object, Blend, Make. You can also use the blend tool from the toolbar. Now, your pattern might not look like this one, so double click on the blend tool to open the blend options and make sure the spacing is set to specified steps. Also, enter an odd number of steps. You can enter any number you want. Check the preview box to see the changes. But it's very important that the number is odd because you need a line that passes through the middle of your artboard. So you need this diagonal line here, and if you enter an even number, you won't have it and the pattern won't be seamless. So press OK to save it. Next, we are going to crop this shape, but before that, we have to expand it. So go to Object, Expand, make sure that all the boxes are checked and press OK. Now we have 11 lines that have a stroke applied to them. So I'm going to go to Object, Expand again and press OK. As you can see, now we have a fill color and no stroke. Next step is to crop the pattern. I'm going to create a rectangle that's the same size as my artboard. And then I'm going to make sure that it's perfectly aligned to the artboard. If you can see the Align panel, you can open it from Window Align. So select both shapes and using the Pathfinder tool, you can open them from Window Pathfinder. Crop the shape. Just press the crop button and as you can see, this is our pattern tile. You can save the pattern by dragging it to the swatches panel or you can add the background to it. Our swatch now has a transparent background. So let's add the background. I'm going to switch to the rectangle tool again and choose a different fill color. Then I will create another rectangle that's the same size as my artboard. I'm going to align it again and then go to arrange and send to back. So now I will select both shapes and drag them to the swatches panel. So let's select the pattern and draw a rectangle. So there you have it. This is a seamless diagonal striped pattern. So as you can see, today we've made a horizontal diagonal pattern, a vertical diagonal pattern, and a diagonal striped pattern. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial, and if you want to see more tutorials, please subscribe to my channel or visit my blog. More tutorials are coming soon.